Welcome to Heaven Singh Academy. Today we are going to discuss about the coordinate geometry. I hope you will enjoy this topic, very important topic. This topic is just introductory in your class, in class 11th. This is something more about coordinate geometry you have to study. And in IIT, this is very important topic for IIT examination. Almost 2-3 questions usually. Minimum question can be asked out of the 30 questions. So that is why this topic is very important. And once you understand this, you will enjoy this topic definitely. And the term geometry, generally students will not like this, but this is the coordinate geometry. Nothing to do much about geometry. It is something a very different one than the geometry. So we have to learn about coordinate geometry today. So coordinate geometry. First of all, we would like to discuss about what is coordinate. What is coordinate? Then we will discuss about geometry. To analyze this, let us understand what is the meaning coordinate. And to understand this, I am just asking you one question. There are two cities, say, city A is here and city B is here. City A is here and there is another demarcation, city B is here. And another city C is here, which is from 5 km from this place, I can say 5 km from this place, and 9 km from this place, 9 km from this place. From two different destinations, distance is given. And what exact location, where the point is. So one can describe it like that 5 km from city A and 9 km from city B, there is a city that is called city C. So this city is described with the reference of two distances. One distance from city A, another distance from city B. Then one can say 5 and 9. There are two references, and on the basis of that we will be able to calculate this. That 5 and 9 are two consecutive values, a pair of values, which will define the distances from two different cities. Another way, one can say, why not from one point I can define this distance, but to find the accuracy, some angle also needed with the horizon. So that is why there are two systems of coordinate. One in which two distances are only mentioned, that is called Cartesian system. Because this theory is being given by Descartes, and therefore this distance is called, this system is called Cartesian system. Descartes was the mathematician who has given this idea, and therefore this is called Cartesian system. The another system in which I can describe this length from to one distance only but an angle, that is called polar system of coordinates. That you have not to study right now. You have to just know about the Cartesian system. So let me describe about Cartesian system. The theory given by famous mathematician Descartes, and on the basis of his name, the system is called Cartesian system. So what is Cartesian system and what is coordinate? Coordinate of any point can be determined from the distance measured from two perpendicular axes. This is called x-axis, this is called y-axis, then of course this will be y-dash and this is called x-dash. So this is a two perpendicular axes, two perpendicular lines called x-axis, y-axis. This is x-axis, y-axis, and the point of intersection of this is called origin. X-axis, y-axis and origin. To represent position of any point, what to do? Suppose point lies here, then the The position of this point can be determined by two consecutive distances. One distance parallel to y-axis and another distance can be measured parallel to x-axis. The distance parallel to x-axis called distance along x-axis. Distance parallel to x-axis called distance along x-axis, that is called x-coordinate, and the distance along y-axis called y-coordinate. So two distances, two coordinate, x-coordinate and y-coordinate, this is the two mutually perpendicular distances, and one is x-coordinate. X-coordinate is what? Nothing else but distance parallel to measured parallel to x-axis. Distance measured parallel to x-axis, this is what? X. That is, this one is x. Distance along x-axis is x-coordinate, and the distance measured along to y-axis, that is called y-coordinate. So x-coordinate and y-coordinate are two values which will define the position of a point with respect to a Cartesian system. This is a Cartesian system, and on the basis of this Cartesian system we can find the place value of x and y. So x and y are two system, two values which will define the position of point A in this Cartesian system. Distance along this side is always measured as positive, and distance along from origin this side is positive direction. Distance along this side is positive, so y coordinate is positive, x coordinate is positive this side. In this side opposite direction it is a negative, so x dash towards x dash the value are negative, and towards y dash the value are also negative. It means what? The whole system is divided into four system, four quadrant. Quadrant means four parts. This is x-axis, x dash axis, axis is same, x dash, y-axis, and this is y dash. This is origin. Now the complete plane, this plane is divided into four segments. Part 1, part 2, part 3 and part 4. These are called quadrants. Four quadrants are there. This is called first quadrant. Quadrant means 1/4 quadrant. This is second quadrant. This is third quadrant. And this is fourth quadrant. So all this plane, any plane can be divided into mutually perpendicular line, can divide in four quadrant system. Four quadrant, four parts. The whole plane, this plane is divided in two parts. If I draw a line, if I draw a line here, then the whole world divided into two parts. Those which lie this side or those which lie that side. But if I draw two mutually perpendicular lines, then the whole area divided into four parts, four segments. These are called as quadrant. So four quadrant, first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant and fourth quadrant. These are the four quadrant system, and in this four quadrant system there are some sign convention as well. So sign convention, sign convention in four quadrant system. If this is a x, this is x dash, this is y, this is y dash, then what will happen the quadrant system? In first quadrant, x, all values of x along x-axis in this side measured, that will be always positive. So distance measured along this direction is positive as it is given. So here x coordinate will be positive, and y coordinate also, distance along this side, if any point lies here, then the distance measured along y-axis is positive, so that will be also positive. So any value which will be positive and positive, any point which will have positive coordinate, both coordinates are positive, x coordinate is positive, y coordinate is positive, it must lie in first quadrant. So this is the first quadrant, you know, positive, positive. this side x coordinate would be negative, and y coordinate is what? Y coordinate point distance along it, y axis is measured positive, so y coordinate is positive. So negative positive will be in second quadrant, in first quadrant, in second quadrant. In third quadrant, suppose point lie here, point lie here, anywhere in this one, then the distance along x axis is this direction, that is x coordinate, distance along x axis is x coordinate. So distance measured along this x axis will be always negative, so x coordinate will be always negative. And to get y coordinate, distance must be measured along y axis, that will be also in negative direction, will be also negative. So negative negative lie in third quadrant. And here, if point lies here, then the distance along x axis is positive and distance along y axis is negative, so this will be positive and negative. In other way, x coordinate is distance along x axis, or in other way, you can say distance from y axis. Distance along x axis or distance from y axis. For example, x coordinate is nothing else but this is y axis, distance from y axis. And similarly, y coordinate is the distance along y axis, but we can, in other way, we can say y coordinate is distance from x axis. From x axis, this distance is, distance of point from x axis is called y coordinate. So y coordinate is distance from x axis, and x coordinate is distance from y axis. So again, try to understand. For x coordinate, I have to write first. So x coordinate is what? Distance from y axis. And from y axis, if I consider this distance, this will be always positive direction, because this direction is always positive. So that will be positive. And distance along x axis is x coordinate, so that will be also positive. But y coordinate is distance from x axis. Distance from x axis means from here, this distance is positive direction, so y coordinate will be also positive. If point is here, then x coordinate is distance from y axis. From this y axis, this distance, this direction distance is negative, so it will be negative. X coordinate is negative. And y coordinate is distance from x axis, that is, this is the direction where the x axis, from x axis start measuring this distance, that will be positive. So distance from x axis is positive, and therefore y coordinate is positive. Now if point lie here, then distance from y axis, this direction, that will be negative. So x coordinate is negative, and distance from x axis, that is from here, x axis is this. From this, if I would measure like this, then this direction is the y negative distance, and therefore y coordinate would be also negative. In this coordinate, if point lies, then distance from y axis is positive, because this direction is always positive, and distance from x axis, that is negative coordinate, because distance along x axis is in negative direction, so y coordinate would be negative and x coordinate would be positive. So we have learned this four quadrant system: first quadrant, second quadrant, third quadrant, and fourth quadrant. And any or value, any point which will lie in first quadrant, both has positive coordinate. A point lying in second quadrant, its x coordinate must be negative and y coordinate must be positive. Clear? If point lies in third quadrant, both the quadrants will be negative. X coordinate negative, as well as y coordinate also negative. If point lies in fourth quadrant, then x coordinate will be positive and y coordinate will be negative. So on the basis of this nature of the coordinate, we can decide that that point, a particular point, lies in which quadrant. For example, let me discuss for a few questions. If I write point, a point is which, in which quadrant, let me write some question, in which quadrant the following points lies, right? First question, 3 minus 7. Second question, 4 minus 4 minus 3. third question. What is this? Minus 7, 8. Fourth question. 2 minus, minus 2, 5. What is that? So, where this lies? First quadrant is positive, second one is negative. So, where it lies? Will you tell me? Positive, negative. Where is positive, negative? Positive, negative is in fourth quadrant. So, this point must lie in fourth quadrant. Negative, negative, both quadrants are negative. Negative, negative lies in third quadrant. So, that point lies in third quadrant. And this is what? Positive, negative, positive. Negative, positive lies in second quadrant. And here, this is a negative, positive. Negative, positive again. Again the same thing. So that will also lie in second quadrant. And if there is any other point, 3, 5, both of them are positive. So it lies in first quadrant. Like that. So if I have to mark all these on Cartesian system, how can I mark it? Because I have written this, we know, without drawing, without marking, without coming to that point, that where the point actually exists, we are able to say in which quadrant these points lie. But actually, if I have to mark all these points on Cartesian system, then how we come to know that where they lie and what will be the value. So let me mark all these points in their respective positions so that I can analyze, and this is truly come to knowledge that yes, in this quadrant this will lie. So I have written this. This is 0, x-axis, right? And this is y-axis. I have written this is x dash and this is y dash. Okay, so let me mark some points that we need actually. So we can write here 1, this is 2, this is 3, this is 4, this is 5, this is 6, this is 7, this is 8. In similar way, that can be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, like that. Similarly, here it will be minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, minus 4, minus 5, minus 6, minus 7, right? Like that. And similarly here, it can be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, like that, right? So, we have to mark first of all, x3, y minus 7. x3, where is x3? x3 is here only. x3 is here. And y minus 7, y is minus 7 there. So, these points, 3 points, the distance along y-axis, along x-axis, the distance along x-axis is 3, that is why x coordinate is 3. So this distance is from y-axis, this distance is 3, and from x-axis, this distance is minus 7, and therefore this point lies at 3, minus 7. So this is the point which lies here, 3, minus 7. I hope you got it. X3. X coordinate is what? Distance from y-axis. So y-axis and positive direction distance is measured this side because 3 is positive. So distance measured from y-axis in positive direction 3 unit. If it was minus 3, then we can make measure like this. But distance measured along x-axis, that is 3 unit, and minus 7, that is 7 unit distance, but in negative direction. And what is y coordinate? Y coordinate is distance from x-axis. So this is x-axis. We can measure 7 unit distance in negative direction, and that will be here only. So 3 minus 7 is this point, right? Now, again, I need to write second point, minus 4 minus 3. X is minus 4. X coordinate is minus 4. That is 4 unit distance in negative direction. And x coordinate means distance from y-axis. So this is y-axis, from this, 4 unit distance in negative direction, 1, 2, 3, 4. This is the point where we have to measure. And also, y-coordinate is also minus 3, that is 3 unit distance from x-axis in negative direction. So this will be the point, 3 unit from this and 4 unit from this, that is minus 4, minus 3 is the point which will be the second one. Now, the second point, minus 7 and 8. X is minus 7, but Y is 8. So minus 7 lies here because this is minus 6. So minus 7 must lie here, something like this. Minus 7 and 8 is also here also. So minus 7, x is minus 7, that will be the line where this will describe x, minus 7, and this is called describe 8. So this point is called minus 7 and 8. So minus 7 8 lies in second quadrant actually. That is what I have written. Minus 2 and 5, x minus 2 and y 5, x minus 2 here and y 5 here. So this point will be, this point will be minus 2 and 5. So that point is described as minus 2 and 5. The next point is 3 comma 5. X is 3 and Y is 5. So this point will be 3 comma 5. So these are some points which can be demarked on the basis of their merit, that whether they are positive or whether they are negative. Let me mark some other points, that is 2 comma minus 3. And also some points like 6 comma 2 and some other points like minus 3 comma 4, like this. So what will happen? So 2 comma minus 3, will you tell me where to x2 y minus 3? X2 is this, y minus 3 is this. So this is the point which is 2 comma minus 3, we can write here. Now another point is 6 comma 2. X is 6 and Y is 2, so positive direction 2, that is 6 comma 2. Okay, now minus 3 and 4, X is minus 3, that is this, and Y is 4, that is positive direction, so this will be minus 3 comma 4, that will be point. Minus 3, this, and 4 is positive direction, so positive direction. So one can move and one can generate the points in their respective system depending upon the merit of the point, depending upon the sign of the point, that what coordinate carry what sign, depending upon the sign, it will be decided that in which quadrant it will lie. Got the point? Right? So hopefully you will be able to understand this, that what the coordinate is. Basically, coordinate is nothing else but the demarcation of a point, demarcation of a point with respect to two Cartesian parallel or perpendicular, two perpendicular lines. Two perpendicular lines are called axes, named x-axis and y-axis. The distance from these two perpendicular axes will represent the coordinates of the point, and for demarcation of that point, what the distance is required, that is called Cartesian representation of the point. Cartesian representation of point, and that is also called Cartesian coordinates. So Cartesian coordinate of a point is nothing else but representation of this point with respect to x-axis and y-axis. So, as we have discussed, that distance from x-axis is called y-coordinate and distance from y-axis is called x-coordinate. Distance from x-axis is called y-coordinate and distance from y-axis is called x-coordinate. This is x-axis, this is y-axis, right? And this is y-dash, this is x-dash, right? So, this is origin, O for origin. What is the distance from x-axis if point lies here? Point lies here. What is the distance from x-axis? Will you tell me? Distance from x-axis is nothing else but zero. Because a point lies here only on x-axis. This point lies on x-axis only. So distance from x-axis is zero. I am standing here at Arvind Singh Academy. What is the distance of mine from Arvind Singh Academy? That is zero. Because I am standing here only. If you are staying at your place, at your home, and what is the distance of your home from where you are standing, that is zero. So point lies on x-axis, it means the x-coordinate will be zero. And this point also lies on y-axis, so that y-coordinate will be also zero. distance from y-axis is 0, distance from x-axis is 0, and therefore coordinate of origin is 0, 0. Coordinate of origin is 0, 0, 0, 0. Okay. On x-axis, if points lie, suppose here a point P is lies, what is the distance of this point from y-axis? That is x-coordinate. So x-coordinate something can happen. But what is the distance of distance from x-axis? Because point lies on x-axis, so distance from x-axis is itself 0. So distance from x-axis is what? Y-coordinate. And y-coordinate is 0. So if point lie on x-axis, their y-coordinate is always 0. So this is the second point you need to remember. If any point lies on x-axis, its y-coordinate is always 0. Coordinate is always 0. Right? Next point is, similarly, if any point lies on y-axis, then its x-coordinate is always 0. X-coordinate is always 0. Right? Point lies on x-axis, their x-coordinate is 0. Point lie on x-axis, their y-coordinate is 0. And point lies on y-axis, their x-coordinate is 0. So if point P lies on x-axis, their coordinate can be written in general form x, 0. If the distance is x, x-coordinate is x, but y-coordinate is 0. Similarly, point lies on y-axis, their x-coordinate will be 0. Y-coordinate can be the distance from x-axis. So like this, this is what any point lies on x-axis, their y-coordinate is always 0. Remember this, y-coordinate is 0. And if point lies on y-axis, their x-coordinate is always 0. So remember these two facts, and I hope you understand what is the x-coordinate and y-coordinate. My purpose for today's lecture is just to deal and analyze that you will be able to understand what is exactly x-coordinate and y-coordinate, and how can you decide that where and in which quadrant the point lies. Right? I hope you understand it. Thank you very much. Thank you very much for watching this video, and subscribe our channel. Also, you can visit with our website, that is www.arvindsingh.com, right? For more study material, arvindsingh.com. You can visit for more written study material, theory and questions, some illustration, examples, everything is there. So you can visit with our website. And if you want to ask anything, you can mail me at arvindsingh academy@gmail.com. Right? Thank you. Thank you very much for watching. Thanks a lot. God bless.